Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. Yes, we're easing on into that evening hour of Friday, getting the weekend started. And I thought I would come through with the come through and bring y'all some videos to partake of, starting off with Friday, working through Sunday. Okay, because I ain't doing that. I'm bored. Might as well just sit and talk to y'all. I ain't got nothing else to do. I mean, I have something else to do, but I just don't feel like doing it, like cleaning the house. So I'll save that till tomorrow. But I thought I'd just get down here, crank up, or I should say crank out some videos tonight. And I just came across this one. It may interest you. It may not interest you. Okay. If it don't resonate, just pick another video to look at, and then I'm sure you'll find something that'll give you a kiki ha ha laugh and put you to bed. All right. But I'm talking about today, William Shatner, Star Trek man, Captain Kirk, okay? Captain T. William Kirk or something like that. Well, I don't know what the name was, but anyway, his real name is William Shatner. And he played a space chief something out there. I forgot what the name of the ship he was on. The Enterprise, yes. How could I forget the Enterprise, okay? But anyway, he is teaming up with Jeff Bezos. He is the one that's running around here with the founder, owner of Amazon. Then he took a step back and, you know, he's still like a heavy ranking person at Amazon. But he let somebody else run it. He still owns it though. But got this story from New York Post. And they're talking about Bezos, which is the man on the right. You know, he owned that Flying Fox yacht that Beyonce and Jay-Z was just lounging in on and renting it out for astronomical amount of money per week, which I felt that they have a lot of money too. They should have bought their own yacht. Okay, but like I said, they might not be water type people that want to be on the water 24/7. They mostly probably like land, like most folks, and like to be on the water when it's convenient, okay? But anyway, these is the four crew member, I guess, of the spaceship called the Blue Origin, okay? Man got the Flying Fox, pretty-ass yacht. Ooh, it's beautiful. Now he's taking off into another side and trying to go outside of the borders of the world. He's trying to go up in space, y'all. Well, I guess he have been up in space. So he got a little space science under his belt, I guess you should say. And he's looking for a new world to go to. Cause we done damn near tore up this one down here with all the smog and the pollution and the, what do you call it, the climate control and the ozone layers. Now they trying to go find somewhere else to go and think we ain't going to follow behind them. Please. Woo, we going to follow, honey. We going to follow. But anyway, that's a very interesting story. Shatner, no, he don't really need to be going up there. He damn near 100 years old. And he talking about he want to go up in space. And Jeff said, yeah, come on, take a ride with me. It's free. You can go. You'll be the oldest member of the party to go on up in space and see what you feel about it. I'm like, now, I have my conspiracy theories, friends. And they're saying, like most people probably have thought, and they can't cure cancer, but they can go up in the moon, leave this earth, go up to the moon, and any other galaxy they want to travel to, but they can't fix cancer. Make it make sense. Okay, they can't wipe out all the diseases, even this COVID thing we're going through. Okay, but they can go up to the moon and do all other, what do you call it, extraordinary feats that just mind boggles the brain. But they can't cure simple illnesses that have been plaguing humanity for decades, for centuries. So Jeff said, let's just go and go to space. It's just like we sailing on our yacht, on my yacht, venturing into another country, another land, another state. Just depends on where the water takes us, okay? But he going up in the air now. I said, boy, wouldn't you want to be rich and just have playtime all the way around? Just all the way around you. Playtime, playtime, playtime. Man didn't work hard all his life. Founded a few businesses. Became a zillionaire. Forget billionaire. He probably a zillionaire. But we're going to get into the story. Samantha Ibrahim wrote it up for us on today around 2:12 p.m. She titled it William Shatner to Go to Space in Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin Rocket Ship. I'm like, boy, when they say a rocket ship, I was thinking a Rocket Man. Elton John, wanna be a rocket man. I know y'all know that song. I can't think of the words right now, but y'all know where I'm going with it. Okay, they said William Shatner would take flight to the stars in October aboard Jeff Bezos' spaceship. William Shatner is going from starring in Star Trek to seeing the real stars above. The science fiction actor, 90, told y'all he was damn near 100, will be going to space aboard Amazon's founder, Jeff Bezos' new Shepard rocket, according to TMZ. Okay, that man looked like an alien. I don't care what nobody say. He looked like an alien. But going back to the article, it says Bezos' Galaxy Rider is made by his space travel company, Blue Origin. Shatner will be the oldest person ever to travel to space with this historic ride, TMZ reported. Okay, the Canada native 15-minute flight will occur sometime in October. The outlet also reported that the mission will be filmed for an upcoming documentary featuring the actor who played Captain James T. Kirk on an iconic series. Bezos, 57, first went up to space in July alongside his brother, Mark Bezos, pioneering pilot Wally Funk, who at 82 is the oldest space visitor to date, and rich Dutch student Oliver Damen, then 18 and the youngest person to go to space. Okay, the foursome reached heights of 66.5 miles above Earth on New Shepard and spent about 10 minutes off the ground. I want to thank every Amazon employee and every Amazon customer because you guys paid for all of this. See that? We paid for him to play. Ain't that some mess? We paid for him to play. We going buying on Amazon from everything from panties to garage to camping gear to anything we can even think of imagining buying on Amazon. We paid the piper for him to go play. Ain't that some mess? But anyway, going back, he's thanking everybody. He's thanking the employees. He's thanking the customers. He said, because you guys paid for all of this. Bezos told reporters after returning from the trip, so seriously, for every Amazon customer out there and every Amazon employee, thank you from the bottom of my heart very much. It's very appreciated. The atmosphere, so be it, but when you get up above it, you'll see it's this tiny little fragile thing, the billionaire continued. That's very profound. It's one thing to recognize that intellectually. It's another thing to actually see with your own eyes how fragile it really is. And that was amazing. Okay. And it just shows the booster of the Blue Origin. New Shepard sits on a landing pad after powering the rocket into space on July 20th. So this joker already done went up to space. Or what he feels he done went up to space. Because I'm still not bought on the whole idea. Okay, I'm still not bought on the whole idea. But that's just me and my conspiracy thinking type mind. Don't judge me. I won't judge you. But y'all, what y'all think about William Shatner going up there at 90 years old? I'm like, are they going to have some paramedic stuff up there in case he freak out? In case he start want to have a heart attack or something? Feel like he can't breathe? Some people just can't. I don't know what's wrong with Shatner. I don't know. I guess he's bored. So he's teaming up with Bezos. Yes, he's teaming up with him to go out of space and see what it truly looks like there in the outer galaxies. You would have thought he had enough playtime with Star Trek, giving up all this craziness that we were seeing. And we were buying it all. I know I was a sci-track fan. I was a sci-fi fan. Yes, I was. I love watching different episodes of Star Trek. I still watch them, to tell you the truth, on it's not on Netflix. Might be on Hulu. But then it could be on Netflix too. But I still watch the oldie but goodies, and that's one of them. Star Trek was a winner. It really was. The series outdid itself. But yeah, honey, Captain T. James Kirk, aka William Shatner, going up in space for real, y'all, for real, for the real, real. But y'all get down in those comments and y'all let me know. Is William too old to be trying to go up? Just trying to go up and do. Is he striving for his bucket list? Is this one thing on the bucket list he wants to accomplish in real life before he kicked the bucket? I'm like, man, gravity, your age. I don't know if it's a good deal. But you gonna go up there with the founder, the chief commander. I don't know if you'll come back. I don't know. Cause he look like an alien myself. At least I think he does anyway. But anyway, that's all I got for this video, y'all. Get down in the comments, y'all. See, like I'm getting sleep. I took a Benadryl, but I think it's taking its effect on me right now. Do y'all think we really going to space? Do you think they really have gone up to space and planted stuff and be monitoring it? What y'all think, guys? Or y'all have a mind like me and be thinking outside the box? Like, why you won't show us proof? Why every ordinary people just can't go to space? We should be able to accomplish that by now. We send astronauts up there. They're sitting up there calling themselves, going up there doing missions and stuff, testing to see if there's any other life forms out there. You know what I'm saying? Showing the Milky Way, showing all these other little things, little stars. So I'm like, okay, is it really true then? Why haven't we been going for centuries now up to the moon? Just for recreation, just like we go to another country and visit. We can go up there to the moon if it's really a doable thing. But anyway, y'all let me know what y'all think, okay? Just let me know what y'all think. And I'll see y'all next video. Bye-bye.